Hey everyone, I've been reading a bunch of posts on the lagginess of the iX12 and laggy switch change reports. So a few people have asked me to do a video on what I did to mine. Mine runs pretty snappy, I think. So let's jump right in and I'll show you what I did to mine and hopefully it'll work for you. I can't guarantee anything, so do this at your own risk. Okay, so I want to do all this real time for you, so I'm going to turn it on. You can fast forward through this part. I seriously doubt anything that I did sped up the boot up time, but you can fast forward this and we'll see if it's any faster. I doubt it. Model changes probably aren't any faster either, so we'll do that at the end of this too, just see. Tons of snow here, no flying going on, so I just have to make these videos. Hope you guys like them. Alright, that was less than a minute, I think. Air wear hasn't started yet, doesn't look like. Maybe that would have been faster if I tapped on airware. I don't know. So we're about a minute now. Maybe I'll have to try that again. Just see. Airware usually starts itself, so I don't touch it, but maybe it'd be faster. Don't know. All right, that looks like maybe it was a little bit over a minute to get to this screen. So anyway, here we go. So your drop-down screen, go to settings. And then scroll down to apps, and up here you can see it says downloaded. Let's see if I can get that closer. I'm just gonna go right to disabled and I'll show you what I disabled. So I'll scroll through these, read them off. Android live wallpapers, Chrome, Google app, Google Play Music, Maps, and Street View. So those are all apps that take up a lot of space on this tablet. Doesn't have a whole lot of storage anyways. So these are the ones I disabled. And that's pretty self-explanatory. You can go, I'll show you how to disable them. Let's see. So in the apps menu, you can click on one, I'll show you. And there's probably, let's see, that's downloaded. Running. Here's all. This is where you're going to want to do it from. Let's see, this black hole, I'm not sure what that is. Anyway, I'll just click on one. I could probably disable this. I have no idea what it is. It's probably bloatware. But you just click on the app, hit disable. And it says, it's going to tell you this for all of them. If you disable this app, it may crash other apps. So you need to decide whether you want to do that. If you do want to, you would push OK. If not, you hit cancel. I'll disable this and see what happens. And that's all you do. Disable these apps that you're never going to use. So, and then the other thing is go to storage. And this will tell you how much memory and like RAM and flash that you have. Total space. Available, all that good stuff. Cached data, this will clear up a little bit of memory for you. So you can clear that. I'm trying to, I think it automatically, any apps that are running, it's gonna cache some data anyways. So that's basically all I've done. And then one other thing, when I go out to the field to fly, I pull this drop down again. Right here, you can see Wi-Fi and Bluetooth are both on. I hit air mode, turns Wi-Fi, Bluetooth off, and it keeps it running smooth, and it saves battery. That's the biggest part for me. It saves battery. There's nothing else running in the background. And when I'm out in the field, airplane mode's always on. So a lot of you guys might be saying, well, what's cool about the iX12 if you can't play on Facebook? I got a phone in my pocket with me to play music, get on Facebook, Google Maps, all that stuff. The touch interface on this iX12 is just sweet. To set up models, your switch change reports, all that stuff. And that's what I bought this for, is to fly models with, not to get on Facebook and update statuses. So if that's something you want to do, go for it. And I personally, that's just not what it's for me. So I'm going to go in here and I'll switch a model real quick for you, and we'll just see if it's any faster than normal. I'll hit one of these switches and hopefully it doesn't make a liar out of me here. Pretty fast. So see if we can switch a model here real quick. Go to this one, proceed, and you guys can time this. See what you think for yourself, maybe compare it to your own. It's not horrible. By the time I switch models, grab a couple packs, do a few things, change the tunes on my phone, it's usually sitting there ready to go for me. So I hope this helps some of you guys out. Leave me some comments down below. Let me know what you think. Let me know if you have problems with it. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you later.